yes, I do believe that the food systems are and what we eat, you know, because it's not only the food systems, but everything to eat is a very political thing. Because when you can, if you're a consumer and have the choice of what you're buying, you know, actually you have the money and you decide what kind of world you want to see. Because if you eat local, you are transforming, you know, your landscape, your local economy. And if you eat global brands and processed foods, etc., we all know that. But the tricky thing is that food systems were never part of the climate negotiations. And then the way that they are now being inserted in such a rush and with such strong actors, it's because it's already designed to have as an outcome what the solution, the corporate solution for the food system. So it's not that we are addressing the need to dismantle this madness of global monocultures and shipping food all the way around and eating a globalized McDonald's diet. Is now we have this, you know, the need for the financial capital, because it's out of thin air, but it's there, you know, and wants to invest and generate profits and generate patents to actually disrupt. That's the language that the industry has been using. Disrupt the animals as the converters for protein. So they want to produce protein. Of course, it's going to be out of something, you know, mostly soy, but also peas and algae. And even they are talking about, you know, this is so alchemic, you know, transforming, capturing carbon from the atmosphere and transforming it to plastic or protein. So this whole sci-fi world, it could be only a sci-fi world, but then you have this tons, billions of dollars created out of the financial casino that actually pays people to investigate, to research, fund labs, and then you create a reality.